As we continue on with orientation of Business Central, we're now going to do a quick little slide or two on how to show and hide information on both list and card pages. So again, we're back into Business Central. So as we spoke about earlier, this is your main landing page and you can show and hide information directly on the role center if needed. So again, under your personalize, you're going to go ahead and you're going to open up your personalization through your settings gear. If there's things here where you say, well, that isn't really for me, that's not something that I'm going to need. Again, when you click on different areas, so you'll notice that I've got this yellow triangle with my inventory picks to production. Let's say I'm not choosing to turn on advanced warehousing. So I can go ahead and I can remove whatever it is that I don't want. I can also take things like user tasks, and maybe I want to drag and drop that to be a little bit more obvious and in my face, so I can drag and drop that on my main role center. Under more, I can choose to add a field. So this gives me the ability to be able to see, well, is there anything potentially that's being hidden that I would want to show because it would add information. So here, if I do that, I can click on different areas. This will dynamically update on the right-hand side based on where I've clicked to be able to see, am I showing everything that I possibly can. Now, because it's on the main role center, you'll notice that what's actually available could also just be grayed out. So in that case, if something's grayed out and hidden that I actually need, I can right-click and indicate that I want to show that. And again, that also makes it visible. You might see certain areas have this sort of grid line here. So again, that lets me know, and so does this, that this is being hidden. So if this was something that I needed and we're adding value, I can go ahead and show that. But again, oops, it says obsolete. I made a mistake. I can go ahead and rehide it if I need to. Okay. You can also do the same idea on list pages. So for example, if I wanted to, I could open up my list of transfer orders. So perhaps direct transfer is something that I don't need. The same rule applies on my list pages. I can take my triangle. I can just remove what I don't need. On the right-hand side here, I can see my list has updated based on the new page and the new area of the page. So if, say for example, I wanted to be able to see my dimension code for department, I can go ahead and I can just drag that to wherever I want. I can move it around if it didn't land in the right spot, but essentially what I can do is I can just take the fields that I need and I can drag them into my list view so that I can have the information that I need when I need it. I can drill into card pages and I have the same idea. So here, direct transfer again is something that maybe you don't need. So I can go ahead and I can remove anything that I don't need. I can add a field. So again, if anything's hidden that I need, by clicking on the respective area, I can see the fields available. The key thing about card pages is you need to click on the affected area. So if I needed to see what fields I had available for the line area, I need to click on the line area first so that the list updates. The second I click into, say, my header, you'll notice that this list changes. So it is important to tell Business Central the area that you want to show or hide fields so that it can present you with the fields for that specific area from that correct table. You can also, in these areas like the general and the shipment and the transfer from, those are called fast tabs. And in those fast tabs, you can determine what shows when you open the fast tab. So again, I'm just opening it up. You can choose what gets shown when you click on show more. So you can see I have additional fields that populate, and you can actually even show key pieces of information when your fast tabs are collapsed. So there might be key pieces of information that you thought, well, if I could just see it when the fast tab is collapsed, it would allow me to have potentially more real estate on my page and just see what I need. So when you're clicking on these different fields, if you click the show under show more, this will make the option when you first open up the fast tab, you will not see it. But then when you click show more, it will then present that field. Show when collapsed, that is going to be when you collapse or you click on general and you hide all of the fields, what gets shown in the little bar at the top. And then exclude from quick entry means when you hit the tab key, it will basically skip that field. So if you choose to remove it entirely, like we did direct transfer, it comes off your page. Posting date, we're going to indicate that we want to show under show more. And maybe what we'll do is we'll click this as show always, which means that when I open up the general tab, it's immediately going to show. And then again, when you collapse, these are all the show when collapsed. So now when I open up general, I can see that I've got my show less, which hid things like my dimensions. It hid things like my posting group. However, when I click show more, now I've got posting group and my dimensions populate.